It's Friday! Last daily toast of the week. And this one is dedicated to vipergaming23, who was the first to spot the Wolverine toy in my shelf of Sonic Mario stuff. So, vipergaming23 chose this game to be daily toasted today on Friday, which is Sonic Rush for the Nintendo DS. Definitely one of Sonic's more positive adventures of the mid-2000s part of time toast. Anyway, so what can we say about Sonic Rush? First thing that stands out to me the most about Sonic Rush that I just love about this game is the amount of personality in Sonic himself. When you beat a level, he starts dancing around. Sure, he looks like origami, one of those weird Japanese origami Sonics that you can find online, but still, he's just doing all kinds of funky dances, dancing around, so happy that he beat the level, and it's excellent. You compare to this, like, to, like, you know, Sonic Colors for the DS, it's like, whew, beat that level, and Sonic just goes, oh man, I did bad at that level. And he has a little sad face. He's like, oh, come on. I beat their level. It wasn't easy. And give me a C and give me this little sad, frowny Sonic. So that's what I love about Sonic Rush is Sonic dances for you no matter what. And that's cool. This game is one that really reminded us what makes Sonic so great. The speed. This one had that, I forget which button it was. But what was it called? Like the gauge that you have on the side that fills up as you beat badniks and collect rings, and you just hold down that button and you just zoom so fast. That also leads to what I don't like about this game. What I don't like about this game is, well, I guess everyone says this, but the number of times you just can fall into oblivion, the, you know, endless falling and until you die, there's a lot of that. You know, it does have a little bit of, like we see in the classic Sonic games and the classic Sonic gameplay of Sonic Generations, where when you fall down, you fall to a lower layer of level, which may take longer or something like that. But so there's multiple layers you can be running on, and this game does have that a bit, but then it also has so many cheap obstacles where you end up just falling forever until you die. And that's, I'm not a big fan of that. I wish they wouldn't do that in these Sonic games. You know, I feel like Sonic Generations for the classic Sonic levels, I'm talking about the console version, was really good because there weren't a ton of endless drops. You know, you get down to the bottom layer and you just keep going through the level from there. Let's talk about the story a little bit with Sonic Rush. The story revolves around Blaze the Cat, who comes from another dimension to collect the Soul Emeralds, which were stolen by Eggman Nega. First appearance of Blaze, first appearance of Eggman Nega. And oh boy, Eggman Nega. I had a really hard time accepting that character. I thought he was so, I don't know, just kind of a cop-out. I felt like, why bother having an alternate version of him? I mean, it feels like if he was the opposite, because he's the Nega from Negaverse or something like that, if he's the opposite of Eggman, then shouldn't he be good? Shouldn't he be like some kind of a good version rather than being even more evil? Does that mean that the Dr. Robotnik in our universe is secretly a good guy or something, Toast? But then we find out in Sonic Rivals he's actually a descendant of our modern Dr. Robotnik. So I don't know. I do accept him now. I want an action figure of him now. I mean, there's some characters that takes me a while to warm up to. I mean, characters like Big the Cat, loved him on the spot. Thought he was great. The Babylon Rogues, I think they're awesome. I've always thought the Babylon Rogues were awesome, right? Other characters, Charmy B, I did not warm up to very quickly. Now, they did to Mighty the Armadillo. Who else? Shadow. Oh, I hated Shadow when he came out. Especially when you beat the level and he's like, I'm the coolest! Oh, come on, Shadow, you suck. Did I say that? Yeah, okay, so I've come to peace. I'm okay with Shadow now. But when Sonic Adventure 2 first came out, I didn't like Shadow at all. Same with Rouge. I thought Rouge was stupid, too. It took me years and years and years to accept Shadow and Rouge. It really did. Silver, I was excited for. I thought he would be cool, and he ended up being dorky. But now I love him because he's such a dork, because he's so stupid. I think he's a fun character. And I like Silver for that. Blaze, I accepted right away. I think Blaze is cool. Blaze is a cool character. I liked Cream right away, too. Of course, Tails, Knuckles fell in love with him instantly. Sonic and Robotnik, too. So, yeah, Sonic characters I find are hit and miss, but if they stick around, I find I eventually like them. Except Chris Thorndike. I still hate Chris Thorndike. He's still a butt. Anyway, I'm getting kind of ranty here. One thing I love about this game when it came out was the 2.5D graphics. So here we got Sonic, you know, he's on like a slide. He's like, in the background, in the foreground, in the background, in the foreground, you know. So that was cool. The boss battles are very impressive looking, you know, how they're all 3D-ish and stuff. So they can be challenging at times. And then we got the differences between Sonic and Blaze. So I had to put my Sonic toy down. You know how, like, Sonic and Blaze play the same levels, but they're in different orders. I think Blaze starts in, like, the casino level or something like that. And that's cool. And then Sonic has the bonus levels to collect the Chaos Emeralds, just like any 2D Sonic game. But Blaze doesn't. She just collects the Soul Emeralds just, you know, by beating the levels, which is cool, because I don't want to do those levels again. As much as I do like the bonus levels in Sonic Rush, that they, like most Sonic bonus levels, they can be a bit stressful. They're based on the Sonic 2 bonus levels, where you're in a half pipe, and you're collecting orbs, you know, instead of rings. And when they're coming at you so fast, I find that stressful. I really do. I did back in Sonic 2. I did in Sonic Heroes. And I do in this, you know. I really do much prefer the Sonic 3 bonus levels, where if you miss a spear, you can go back for it later. You don't have, it's not just like a one chance thing. That's just me, though. That's just me. I think these bonus levels are actually a lot better than most bonus levels in Sonic games, though. So, yes, toast. Vipergaming 23, this was for you. Everybody, have a wonderful weekend, and I'll see you on Monday. Toast!